Hey guys, so today this video is about me.
Yeah, I usually don't allow that on this channel. It's usually just about me, but no. It's about something that it's the opposite of what people usually think. Like when women go in and get breast augmentation, it's usually to put something in, but not to take something that was put in out.
Well, so maybe we should say what this video is about.
That's what I'm leading to. That's called a segue.
Oh. So tomorrow morning, I am having a breast explant surgery. And what that means is my breast implants are being removed. And I am also having it's called a masoplexy, I believe, which is a breast lift. And they cut away excess skin and they reposition my nipples so that they're...
I want to get my nipples.
Yeah, where they're supposed to be. Symmetrical. All that. Oh, and they're going to make my areola smaller. Didn't tell you that part.
I didn't know that. I like bigger. I like to be like pepperonis.
It all sounds painful. But it's August 8th. So tomorrow morning, August 9th, I go in for surgery at 10:15. So to tell the backstory on this, I went on July 28th, for a consult at the plastic surgeon to discuss the option of having this done. And I was able to get a surgery date rather quickly because if this date didn't work, I was going to have to wait until September after Mark's finishing his competition season. So why am I getting this done?
If I would have known about the autoimmune issues caused by this, and the fact, if I would have known about inflammation, then what I know now, and this wasn't me pushing her to get this, was her thing, yeah. Her idea. I was completely indifferent, don't care. But if I knew then what I know now about inflammation, I would have put down a fight. I would have fought tooth and nail to make sure this doesn't happen, because the inflammatory response to breast implants is scary.
So I got them first in December of 2009. So it's been about 11 and a half years. My implants are silicone, gummy silicone, and they are over my muscle and they are 450 cc's. So I started off as a very small 36A and now—
Big fun bags.
God, my boobs are huge. I've gained 45 pounds since having them in. Despite continuously working out and eating healthy for the last 11 and a half years, I don't think I've ever lost weight since they've been in my body. A year and a half after I had them in, I had a very weird sinus issue that we've talked about before. I had a golf ball sized fungus in my sphenoid sinus. So you have sinuses here, you have sinuses here, but your sphenoid is straight back. And it is on the other side of a bone from your pituitary, which is your brain. So it was a fungus that grew to a golf ball size. It eroded the bone. And fortunately, I didn't lose my vision or anything from it, but they were able to operate through my nose and remove it. I've had chronic sinus infections ever since. I use daily sinus rinse and antibiotic. But at that time when I got this, we asked the doctor, I remember very clearly in North Carolina, why didn't my body fight this off? And he said that I was like 30 something at the time. I was young and healthy, and he didn't know why my body didn't fight.
He said bad luck.
Bad luck was my diagnosis. I was also tested for autoimmune diseases at that time because typically a person with an autoimmune disease is one that its body wouldn't fight off this very normal fungus that is in our environment. It grows, it was Aspergillus. It grows on bread. It grows in leaf piles and such. So, at that time, didn't put two and two together that it was possibly the implants that my body was fighting off, so my body couldn't fight off the fungus. Since then, I've had thyroid problems, hormone problems, fatigue, tiredness, skin problems, weird, hyperpigmentation, hives, just several things. And they do recommend that you swap implants out. They say 10 years, a lot of people get way longer, but I just think that's insanity. There's no need to swap them out. I just want them out. I want the silicone out of my body. My hands, my joints and my hands hurt. Sometimes my knees hurt.
You're a fucking mess.
I noticed in the last several months, I feel a lot puffier despite, I control my sodium and work out. I just continued to gain weight, which really sucks because I've consistently worked hard for the last 11 something years. I was a size 4 when I got them in, and now I'm a size 12, and it sucks. So tomorrow we go in and they're going to be removed. Post-surgery, what does that look like? I probably have a week of taking it easy. Probably won't drive for about 5 days at least.
Which I think all women shouldn't be able to drive.
Luckily, they are over my muscles, so hopefully I should heal quicker. I also shouldn't need drains, hopefully.
Drains, like, they hang down and just drains your titties.
They put a tube, like, in here, and it goes all the way out, and they're coiled in there, and it comes out your armpit, and you have these little drains that collect fluid, and you have to empty them, and you have them in for, like, over a week, and...
It's like a poop bag.
It's, you know, so I guess it's only when they cut muscle that I don't know. So
well,
I
there's less trauma if it's subcutaneous versus intramuscular.
But he said, you know, obviously we'll find out tomorrow after I come out of surgery if I have them or not. I'm hoping I don't. If I don't, it's going to be something we keep a very close eye on to make sure I'm not, you know, developing any fluid under there. So that is the plan. What else do I need to talk about? What did I forget?
I just want to kind of say something. You know, I actually am a huge advocate of people not being fat. You know, it's my thing. I do not want people to be fat because it leads to, for example, 78% of major COVID hospitalizations are due to obese people. Obesity increases your comorbidities of everything. So you'll occasionally have a smart ass online, well, your wife's not lean or shit like that. Now, here's the thing. First of all, I don't care what social media says. I think we're past that. But I am all about, like, I coach at marklowblinder.com. I coach hundreds of people. I've coached thousands of people. And thermodynamics is a real thing. If I cut your calories, you're going to lose fat. Period. The end. There's a caveat. Unless you have a metabolic or a medical condition. I live with this woman. I see what she does. I know what we keep in our house. This woman has defied the laws of thermodynamics. I'm talking about, she doesn't, now people always ask me, Mark, how do you stay so lean? I'm like, I train really hard. So even when I want to eat what I want to eat and I go over the calories, I burn it off. You know, she trains with me up until I started training with the Oreo squad, Courtney and Rucker. Yeah. Up until last week, she's my training partner.
I'm consistently 4 to 5 days a week at the
hard
gym.
This bitch trains crazy. I'm talking like she keeps up with me, and I'm called the machine. The machine. The future IFBB pro. The machine. And people are like, who do you train with? I'm like, the soccer mom right here. And they're like, they're expecting somebody jacked and lean and tan. And they get none of those. Because whatever those, something is fucking up, okay? Now, we've gone over everything. Her hormones are perfect. Dr. Kurt at Hormone Health and Wellness has her perfect. All her levels are on point. If they're not, he fixes them. Mm-hmm. So we got her hormones down, right? Her diet, it's literally what I do. I got people in amazing shape. Hell, I'm in amazing shape. I know diet. I literally write books. Most of y'all read all the books from the Game Over Cut Diet. I know diet. This woman right here, this woman right here could eat literally a piece of lettuce a day and not lose weight.
Yeah.
And I have no explanation. And for me, what's really fertile till we took 11 years to put 2 and 2 together. But for me, it's fucking frustrating. And I feel like I'm failing as a husband, as a coach, as a man. What these breasts have done, they've done more harm than good to our marriage. I'm just going to vent a little bit. Do you mind?
Okay.
Dude, it's like living with a grandma sometimes. She's always tired.
Yeah, so
she's fatigued.
Let me talk about that. So especially before I was on hormone replacement, it could roll around to like 2-3 o'clock in the afternoon and I would just be so tired. I would be afraid to drive the kids anywhere. So it was not unusual and it still is not unusual.
The HRT helped.
Yeah. And it comes in waves. I don't know if it has to do with my cycle, but there's some times where I just have to fall asleep for 20 minutes or else I'm just not gonna be able to function. I have headaches. Like I said before, I'm like, my hands are swollen. I can tell because the size of my when I put my wedding ring on, like they are, my fingers are swollen. I have small hands generally and they're swollen. A week ago, Saturday, I broke out in hives on my arm. nothing changed, no diet change, no detergent change. It's just a whole bunch of things. When I filled out the form at the doctor's, I was just checking off so many things on the, it's called breast implant illness. I don't think we mentioned that yet. And it's actually the main surgery that the plastic surgeon I am seeing does now.
Everybody's getting them out.
Okay, I went to have my teeth cleaned and happened to mention to the hygienist I was having them taken out. And she said, I'm having mine done next month. Our good friend Brandy Curry, she just posted about it, had hers done. And that was kind of what pushed me over the edge, because her and I have been talking about it on and off for the last year.
Tell me about her results.
She went and got it done and immediately felt better. No headaches, inflammation coming down, weight loss.
She told me she was in tears.
She said the next, like, she was so upset with herself of having done these and feeling like crap for 5 years. I've had them in 11 years and it's just been worse and worse every year. And so that's why I was just like, it's time, you know.
And I'm like, just set it up. We'll figure it out.
I literally went in on July 28th.
Just do it.
And surgery is tomorrow, August 9th.
I'm pushing so hard. I'm like, do it tomorrow.
We'll figure it out.
I need these out. I want my wife back. I'm not going to lie. Like, you guys see how high energy I am. And this is me. I'm not, you know, we're filming this now. It's really not the best. Like, usually I'm much more high energy than even this. And those who've met me in person, I'm always bouncing off walls unless it's like right before bed. Imagine if you're me. And, you know, we were first together, like, she had really high energy, but after the implants, and that's the time frame I'm going by,
for real.
You know, she just became, it's like I've been living with Miss Daisy, bro. Like, she's just like old, like she's on the couch and she snores, it's crazy.
Well, the sinus problems that were caused from this, you know.
I sound like I'm hating. We have a great marriage, but I'm just being real. If this does what we think it can do.
So, if I just feel a little better, it's worth it. And I realize it's possible that I won't, but most people, I think some of the statistics are 80%. The statistic from my doctor was that all but one of the cases he did last year felt better. That's what someone told me. I'm seeing a surgeon that Brandy just saw, my neighbor has used, is on the list of approved surgeons from the breast implant illness list. Like, he's done this for many years and it's the main surgery he's doing right now.
Here's the thing though, worst case, your back will feel better.
Right. So,
like,
yeah.
You still feel better. Like, you have less weight pulling down on your front.
Right. So, I opted not to even ask about fat transfer, which is an option for some people. Essentially, they do a liposuction from like your stomach or your hips or whatever and put that fat in your boobs. But you could result with lumpy boobs. It's another incision point. I don't really care. So it's I'm gonna look much different because I'm like a 36G or H now. I don't even remember. I usually wear sports bras just because they're more comfortable. And I'll likely be a B, maybe. If I'm lucky, I don't even know. I didn't ask because I don't even care.
Nah, who cares, man? It's like
I might have so flat I go get tattoos of flowers. I don't know.
Some flat flower titties.
So yeah. So tomorrow morning. Yep. This is happening. These suckers are coming out. So the other thing I was gonna say is your body creates a capsule around the implant. Google it, look at pictures. Maybe you can edit a picture in here. It is so nasty.
I ain't that good at it.
Okay. So it's like this red sac that gets formed around the implant. So I am having a complete capsulectomy, which means they take the whole sac. And the reason behind that is if there are any toxins in there, the whole thing is coming out and they take it out intact and they will photograph it. They will, what?
I got some to talk about.
And they will also give me my implants back.
I'm gonna put them shits on my desk.
They're like hand exercisers.
So we do have a protocol for, obviously we have all our good supplements. We have ambrosia nectar. We have machine greens, quercetin, all the good shit.
I've been taking tons of nectar.
All the good shit, right? So anyway, my buddy locally has a hyperbaric chamber, which increases healing by 30%. Also, Dr. Kurt was nice enough to prescribe some injectable glutathione, which does help with immunity and healing and all that good stuff.
Quercetin and bromelain is actually one of the vitamins that the doctor gave me that I'm already taking, but I'm taking a little higher dose right now. I'm taking Arnica. I will be doing infrared sauna as soon as the doctor clears me. I won't be able to take a bath, I believe, like soaking in water for several weeks. But once I am cleared, Epsom salt, I have read a lot about women detoxing and it can be a bitch, basically.
Like, well, detoxing for anything like today, just because I did a show this weekend, my body's going through an overload detox, you know, from all the toxins, from not only the mentally and physically competing, but the lactic acid from everything. And yeah, detox is a bitch.
Yeah, so like anything, I just gotta keep eating healthy. A lot of, you know, berries and veggies, you know, antioxidants and vitamins. And, you know, just work on feeling better ASAP.
So that's the story. We're gonna keep you guys updated every step of the way. Honestly, you know, we were actually talking about this backstage at the bodybuilding show. It's like, are you cool with it? And I'm like, dude, like, here's the thing. Like, when you are trying to find a mate, you know, it's like, you know, I was actually talking about this with some of the judges. It was funny because when you're trying to find a mate, you know, you have to look a certain way. And when you're married for a long time, it's like, you know, you just want them to be healthy and you want to be happy. And the whole physical thing is way less. It's way less. And also just the conversation we had is I'm like, I don't care if you like chop off half her face, you know, I'm still going to love her the same. And then they're like, are you sure? And I'm like, dude, haven't you seen those stories about like people who get completely mangled in like a fucking tree chipping accident, you know, and they come out, their face is all fucked up. They're missing like an arm, fucking toes are gone. And then like, they're still there. Their spouse is still there. Like, I just love them just the same. We've been together so long that honestly, this might sound fucked up. I don't give a fuck how she looks. I give a fuck how she acts. Like, I want to feel the love, the energy. I'm a high energy dude. Like, I don't care if she's a 1 or a 10. Beauty's in the eye of the beholder. You know, it doesn't matter to me. And that sounds really anti. That sounds like I'm bullshitting, because I'm literally a walking, talking, stereotypical narcissist. I get on stage, I look at my abs every morning, my fucking Instagram's filled with selfies, like, but I'm not. I do that because I'm a bodybuilder and I try to inspire people to strive for better bodies. But at the end of the day, your body is as good as it was the day before. What does that mean? As long as you're doing something to better yourself, if you're 550 pounds, I'm not gonna look at you and say, you're a fat fuck. I'm gonna be like, what were you last week? Oh, you were 560 pounds? Good work. So it's about where you're going and how you're improving yourself. And for me, like, if y'all in long-term relationships, and if you're not, and hopefully you get to one, you got to understand, it no longer becomes about just sex. And sex is a vital part of it. But, I mean, sex becomes, you know, more emotional than physical. So it doesn't matter if you got big titties flopping in your face. You know, what really matters is what led up to those big titties flopping in his face. What were the other 23 and a half hours like? You know, that's what matters.
It's all about being healthy and feeling good. And to me, taking these out of my body is priority because I want to feel good.
I was more anxious than you were, for the record.
Yeah, and I am having anxiety about surgery. I've only been put under anesthesia, I think, 4 times. Putting them in, 1... my sinus surgery, 2, colonoscopy last year at the end of December. That's a whole nother video. And then this will be the, and when my wisdom teeth were taken out, but that's not anesthesia. That's nitric, whatever the gas, right? So this will be the 4th time under anesthesia. I hate needles. If I can get through the IV going in without them having to do it multiple times, I'll be good because then they can knock me out. Fortunately, when I did have them put in, I recovered super fast. I was up and moving. I think the next day, I think I went shopping with my cousin into the gym while Allie was still in town, like 2 days after implant surgery.
Her pain tolerance is high. So
My goal is not to take the super strong pain meds, just Tylenol if needed, which I need to make sure we have Tylenol.
I was just looking through my pills the other day. We still have hydrocodone from one of my surgeries I never took.
Yeah, I filled a prescription because it was 7 prescriptions.
And
was
in like case you want to have some fun.
$35. We had, you know, insurance covers the prescriptions pretty good. So I have everything ready. Mm-hmm. Mark will have a busy week next week.
So we're going to do this. We're going to update you. I'll update you as soon as she can, like, talk.
Tomorrow afternoon.
She's going to look like absolute shit, so she's going to be mad at that.
We'll put a blanket over my head.
Thing is, the videos that we get the most feedback on is, like, when we went through counseling, people are like, you helped us with this. Hopefully we can help you guys go through this.
And if you're on the fence on whether or not you should get implants, Do a lot of research. You need to know the potential complications. All of this information about breast implant illness did not exist.
No, I would have never.
In 2009, the only thing that was out really was that the original silicone implants that leaked were bad, and I have gummy silicone implants, and the way that it's explained to me is if they rupture, the gumminess keeps them together so they don't leak out into your body. So anyways, really think long and hard before putting any kind of foreign substance or implant into your body. And one of the groups I was in, I even read that a chin implant someone had was causing problems because your body is fighting off something foreign in your body.
We're learning new things every day.
So, you know, just everybody, I understand you gotta live your life and do things that make you happy, but do the research first.
All right, guys, thank you so much. We'll update you next time.
Bye-bye, boobies. Itty bitty titty committee.
Yes. Oh, that's old.
I'm old.
Yes, you are. All right, guys.
All right, wish me luck.
See you next
Thanks.
Time. Whoever you are, whatever you do, there's an outright bar that's perfect for you. And for these bars, these are really special because they're truly unique and different. And I wanted my lovely wife, Katie, to talk about this. What is this amazing bar?
So this is the Sunflower Seed Butter Bar. And actually, this was my idea because we have three kids that go to school. And it's very common for kids that are in, you know, elementary school, middle school age to have peanut allergies. And the teachers will post a sign outside the door that says, no nuts, no tree nuts, no peanuts, no tree nuts, sometimes no dairy allowed in a classroom. So with that in mind, we came out with Sunflower Seed Butter Outright Bars. This is a vegan bar because it is using a vegan protein as opposed to the whey protein that is used in the traditional Outright Bar. It has the Sunflower Seed Butter base. So that means there's no peanuts and there's no tree nuts. Now this product is still manufactured in a facility that has that. So if you have a very severe peanut or tree nut allergy, it is in the same facility, but it is, you know, meant for kids with allergies and to be brought to school where there's other kids around that could have potentially have allergies.
We've thought of everything. You know who else we thought about? We thought about people who want a delicious breakfast, tasting like their favorite mochaccino they can buy from their favorite coffee shop with delicious white chocolate chips. And we also thought about people who want to maximize their gains. Now, when you take in this product called Velocitol, this ingredient, it doubles the power of your protein. So by putting the most delicious, delicious mochaccino white chocolate flavor Outright Bar, we have the Outright Breakfast Bar. Look at that.
I haven't had this one in a really long time, and it's actually one of my favorites. So if you have never had sunflower seed butter, it has a different taste. And I haven't had this in a very long time. I actually really liked it when we first came out with it. I just never remembered. So it's got really big, again, those are chocolate chips
vegan
that do not
chips.
Right, have dairy in them because this is a vegan bar and it's also gluten-free.
Grab that one.
That's really good.
The Outright Bar, we've thought of everything. All you need to do is think about going to your favorite retailer. If they don't have it, tell them to get it. If they do have it, buy at least 1 to 30 boxes of these things. There you go.